Pakistan has been now put in a blacklist by Asia Pacific Group. Previously, it was in a grey list. Financial Action Task Force has already grey listed the Pakistan over terror financing and money laundering charges. So let us look in detail. Asia Pacific Group, in its last meeting, evaluated Pakistan effort for the last 5 years, and it found out that of the 40 parameters, it has failed in 32 parameters. So it has decided to put Pakistan in a blacklist. So what is the significance of this move? The significance of this move is it may face a financial downgrade. It faces a financial downgrade and also faces a restriction on its market. Not only that, Pakistan is now reeling under a financial crisis. 25% of its government revenues is coming from international agencies like IMF and other financial agencies. Now it becomes difficult to manage funds from these organizations. And also, Financial Action Task Force, based on the APG, Asia Pacific Group's blacklisting, may also blacklist Pakistan in the future. So now, what is the road ahead for Pakistan? So Pakistan last week has submitted 450-page complaints documents explaining how it has taken action against JUD chief, JUD or LED chief Hafiz Syed, how it has frozen the assets of JUD and other United Nations Security Council banned organization, and other such bullshits over 450 pages. This document will be reviewed in a blacklist review meeting that will be held in Bangkok in September, and this document will be evaluated against a 27-point action plan set out by FATF for Pakistan, and final decision will be taken on October Paris plenary session. Thank you.